This is the VOA Special English Health Report. Today, we take another look at teaching young people how to build healthy relationships. Last week, we told you 15% of seventh graders said they had experienced physical violence in a relationship with the opposite sex. Seventh graders are about 12 years old. Concerns about dating abuse at such a young age are leading to new programs to teach 11 to 14-year-olds about healthy relationships. The northwestern state of Idaho has had a program for the last few years called Start Strong Idaho. Director Kelly Miller says healthy relationships depend on open, honest communication. And that starts with communication between children and parents. Ms. Miller advises parents to talk with their children anytime they can. Parent-child communication can reduce the risk of abusive relationships. 75% of students in the study said they talked to their parents about the issue of dating violence. A good time to have a conversation about a difficult issue is during a family meal, or after watching a movie or television show together. Kelly Miller says young people need rules and boundaries. They also need the skills to be able to resist pressure to be on the phone all the time, or to text when they should be sleeping. The Start Strong Idaho website offers some advice. For instance, watch out for these signs that a phone could be part of an abusive relationship. Feeling like you have to answer text messages or calls right away. Feeling like the texts you receive have gone from caring to controlling. Being pressured to constantly be on your phone, even when you are with friends. And being pressured to send sexual texts or pictures. Kelly Miller also tells young people not to write anything on Facebook that they would not want their parents or other family members to see. And she reminds them that there is no need to accept friend requests from strangers or to give your phone number to someone you do not know. Start Strong Idaho holds separate workshops for parents and teens and also brings the two groups together. Kelly Miller says during these meetings, families often learn things they never knew about each other. Ms. Miller said, one mom came up and said, I'm so thankful there was this workshop tonight because I found out my son not only was dating, but currently has two girlfriends at the same time and didn't understand the problem with that. And that's the VOA Special English Health Report. I'm Carolyn Prisutti.